Let the black man get upon his person the brass letter, U.S. Let him get an eagle on his button and a musket on his shoulder and bullets in his pocket. There is no power on earth that can deny that he has earned the right to citizenship. These words, spoken by Frederick Douglass, were realized and acknowledged when President Abraham Lincoln issued the Emancipation Proclamation. Overwhelming numbers of black volunteers began enlisting, including 90,000 from the Confederate states, 50,000 from the free states, and 40,000 from the border slave states. Their enthusiasm to join the fight against slavery was astounding, and by war's end, there were over 180,000 black men in the Union Army. Approximately 35,000 black soldiers died during the conflict, yet, in spite of the grave danger, escaped slaves and freed black men from all across Michigan volunteered to put their lives and their freedom on the line to go back to the South to fight for the freedom of others.
I have lived in the state of Michigan since I came up this way as a teen with my mother and father. I wanted to go back and fight for the people I left behind in Tennessee. Unfortunately, we had to wait until it our turn to fight. But now it's here. This my country. Those my people left in bondage. It would be terrible for me. It would be a sin for me not to go back and give my kin and other black people a chance for freedom like I enjoy back in the great state of Michigan.
The character of this country lie bleeding and limp when the noble rush of black-skinned soldiers melted into battle. They faced lead and smoke and death and pierced the heart of slaves. They fought for dreams unfulfilled and babies not born. They fought for dignity and their place in this land. They gave tears and blood for the right to kiss their children at night. They fought for their country and their flag with courage and lead. They fought for their manhood that had been labored, whipped, and beaten from them. They clawed at evil and darkness till each could be called a man. They were runaway slaves who returned as Union soldiers to fight to be called free men. Their courage and gallantry are field posts of America's past, where the piercing light of truth lives.
I was coming in from working out in the fields. It was dark because we worked from Kane C to Kane C. And that when I found out they sold my wife, my mother, my daughter, and even my dog. I had nothing to live for, but I had something to die for. Freedom. It was only one night's run to a stop on the Underground Railroad. And I followed that all the way from Maryland to Detroit. And that when I joined up with the 102nd United States Colored Troops. Thank you.